I hear Washington, D.C. addressing the fact that we, the Native American, the Puerto Rican people, would not be denied. We are not a casino, we're not a circus, we're not an actor, we are the factor. And you need to apologize for what you have done to our people with the mockery. $700 billion would not be accepted to go to war. We, the taxpayers, we deny that, and we will not accept that. We'll come together as a nation, and we'll justify, we'll use that money to do what's right, and that's to serve our people. And that's to give our people what they need. They need the food, they need the trees, and the fruitations. We're not gonna waste that money to go to war and kill each other. I'm telling you, Israel, we right here at the Capitol, Washington, D.C. How that's your boy? Getting back to Philadelphia, that's how we do it.
The pilot of injustice, not be afraid. We have come from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, the birthplace of the independence, and Puerto Rico, which was obtained illegally by the United States of America in 1898. They gave us citizenship in 1917 for the only purpose is to go to war. World War I, World War II, the possible third one, the Vietnam, the Korean War. And my friend, who has been to Iraq twice on two tours, we will not be ignored. We are the people. Puerto Rico is an island of injustice. They will leave you there to die. We are a small island on the coast of the North Atlantic, Puerto Rico. We are American citizens, like everyone here, standing here, taxpayers. They take your money, your hard-earned money, and make weapons of mass destruction.
That was
my people, do not be afraid. We have the right to congregate peacefully and to speak our minds freely. I love all of you. Allahu Akbar. This is the movement. All lives matter. Black lives matter. I am a Puerto Rican man. I am 37. I was born and raised in the welfare system because they have broken the spirit of the Puerto Rican people. We have poor infrastructure. We have poor education. They are closing down our schools. They want to make Puerto Rico inhabitable. They want it to be like a Dubai, where only rich businessmen can go and enjoy. But Puerto Rico, San Juan, was the first city in which the conquistadors made their base to create all this that you see here today. It does not matter if you're black, white, Jew, Muslim, from China, and me and my brother, we're from Puerto Rico, and we represent la gente of Latin America, from Peru, from Colombia, de Cuba, de Santo Domingo. Do not be afraid. I am the servant of a servant of a servant, and behind that gate stands the man that we're all waiting to speak to. He is a performer. He does not have the right to be the president of the United States. If we desire to get him impeached, he has to leave that place. He has to get out of office. I am a peaceful man. This is not a physical war. It's a mental war. It's spiritual. My man's a veteran. He's been in Iraq. He's seen death. He's been on the forefront. I love all you people. Do not be fooled. This is the same government that perpetrated 9/11. This is the same government that does not teach your kids the things that they need to know in the public schools in order for them to make a decision. Puerto Rico, the one-star flag will rise again with or without the help of FEMA or any of the other organizations. Puerto Rico will live forever in the hearts. Take the flag, David.
Yes, sir.
In the hearts of all the people. Do not be confused. We are your servants. We love all of you. You pay taxes, you vote, and what do they do? What do they do? They ignore you, like you are not important, like you are invisible. But Puerto Rican, we have been there for hundreds of years. We didn't ask for this. We did not want citizenship. It was imposed on us. Puerto Rico is a military island. I've been to Puerto Rico. My cousin on the phone told me where he's from, in Humacao, it's like a nuclear bomb was dropped there. They have no water. They have no electricity. My people, they are making them wait to fill out an online application. People in the mountains, they have no signal. How can they get FEMA to give them help when they themselves cannot reach out to them? The police and the military of Puerto Rico are taking the aid and they are destroying it. No one is allowed to help Puerto Rico. They think that we're stupid. We are not stupid. We are the original people. We are highly intelligent and capable of making decisions. He did not win the election fairly. He is not my president, and it does not matter where I stand. It could be New York, Miami, Philly, Connecticut, Pakistan, India, Baghdad, Kuwait, where my friend fought and lost many of his friends. Puerto Rico, que viva para siempre.
Let me check. Yeah. That's right, we're the original people of America. And we cannot allow this president, this actor, to come take our people and pay us like we don't belong. We're the original people. I come here in peace, a veteran, decorated army soldier who served and willingly put my life in the line for you people. You know what I'm saying? And we got this President Trump coming over here, waving $700 billion. And he wanna go ahead and claim that he wanna go to war with Kim and Korea. And we cannot afford that. We cannot afford to destroy our world. We cannot afford this blasphemy that's going on. How can you claim to believe in a God that's all love and unforgiving, and you be hateful and unforgiving? All you nations, all you Queen Elizabeth, all you popes, all you high priests, all you people for all the seven seas on the seven continents of the world, we stand here together.
Viva Puerto Rico! Viva Puerto Rico libre! Que se acabe el abuso con nuestra gente, my people, I love you! Do not be confused!
And I talk to my officers, and I talk to the veterans and my soldiers. We cannot allow no man to puppeteer us. We need to cut the strings off. Let me tell you something. We cannot allow this madness to go on. We are people of consciousness. It's 2017. 2,000 years we've been waiting for the Messiah to come and save us, but the kingdom has been here all along. The Messiah himself told you the kingdom is within you. Isn't that the kingdom here? How long must we wait for the kingdom to be established? We need to unite as a people and stop this mockery that's going on.
Que viva Puerto Rico!
We cannot allow this to go on. We are people of consciousness. They treat us, they steal our languages, they steal our history, they steal our faith, and then they masquerade behind closed doors and kill us and plan to kill us. They don't want to save our people. They want to take our land. And you know what? We need to repent, because you know what? It ain't your fault what the forefathers did to our people. We are the native people. Do you know where you came from? I know where I came from. Myself, a veteran, decorated army soldier who served, willing to die for you people. And this man in the White House hides and go ahead and plan all this mockery and blasphemy that he talks about. He's mocking us, slandering, man, it's murderous. How dare you insult the intelligence of our people? $700, $700 billion for war is unheard of. It's unacceptable. We cannot allow this to go on. We need to come together, you Pope, you from the Vatican, you watching, because they're not gonna watch us. The revolution will not be televised. They want us to be blinded. The news is not giving us good news. They're giving us bad news. And then they smile. They smile at you people. They're giving us bad news. But let me tell you something. The good news is that we are the people. We are the voice of America. And we can come together. We cannot allow this taxation money to go to war. $700 billion is unheard of. I'm a civil veteran of the United States Army. I know we can activate the United States Army, the battalions, to go fly cargoes and put trees where there's no trees, water where there's no water, life where there's no life. But they ain't doing that. They're sending boats to Puerto Rico. We got cargoes that can fly tons of food and supply. We got bodies decaying, people dying, still darkness, lost in the mountains of Puerto Rico. And you mean to tell me that you worrying about the football and you twittering about kneeling? Let me kneel before you and stand before you and speak before you and let you know what's going on. You're a fool and you're the apprentice, and today you're gonna learn who runs the house.
We are the native people, the natural people, the original people who will not be denied. Let's go.